Hello! Welcome to day 5 of my 30-day drawing challenge. If you like, you can also take part and push your creativity with this challenge. You can start whenever you like, because it's not necessary to start with the beginning of a month. You can use any medium and style you like, but try to challenge yourself from time to time. If you like, you can also show me your creations by using the hashtag HelloRambu, but you can also use this hashtag to show me your other drawings. I will put a link to the challenge in the description box, so you can simply download it or make a screenshot of it. Try to be creative every day, but if you're not in the mood to draw, it's okay. You can just continue another day. I want to push your creativity, but it's more important to have fun. Take your time to do the challenge at your own pace. And if you have any questions, just feel free to ask. Today's theme is to create a picture in black and white. For this day, I wanted to create something which tells a story. For my pre-sketches, I searched for different references of Cupids in Love and drew some sketches which you might have seen on Instagram. It took me some time to get a good idea for a dramatic and detailed picture, and I know that some people have problems with kinds of nudity in art, but guys, it's not always sexual. The human body is just natural, and nudity is not a bad thing at all. I think it's the intention behind the nudity that matters. A naked body is an object of desire, but in art, it's far more complex. Most of the time, nudity in art is a symbol. Nude figures can be seen as innocent and purity, but also sexual and sensual. It can also express energy and trigger emotions, power and weakness, pride and shame. It can also stand for freedom and an open mind, but also as a mirror of society. I think nudity is equality, and it's impressive what kind of story nudity in art can tell us. Well, I'm not trying to act like a master of art or something, but I often see people getting offended by nudity in art. Whether it's not pornographic in any kind, or just an anatomical study, or just a pre-sketch of a person who just wants to figure out the proportions first before he adds clothing. I barely can understand the problem of nudity because, let's be honest, we are all naked underneath our clothes. So why being offended? I know it's controversial, but this is just my opinion. But anyways, back to the topic. Yes, she's naked, but why? It's a bit complicated to describe, but I will try it. At first, I wanted to give her some fancy clothing with a huge cutout in the back of her dress. And I usually draw all of my characters without clothing first, so it's easier to see the body shape and the proportions. So one reason why she stayed naked was that I really liked how her butt just looks in a non-sexual way. I was just happy how it turned out, and I don't want to destroy it. The other reason was, do you remember the movie The Last Unicorn? The moment when Schmendrick turned Amalthea into a human to save her life. As an unicorn, she's the purest entity that exists. In her human form, she stays pure, but gets weak and vulnerable. I think it's a defining moment, and this was my inspiration for this. So, with her nudity, I wanted to show her purity and weakness. But what kind of relationship do they have to each other? Is it love? Showing dominance? Does he catch her? Is he trying to rescue her? Or is he just the Lord Saturn himself? All these questions can lead to another story of these characters. But what kind of story do you see in this picture? Who are these persons in your eyes? Any thoughts? This is what I think makes art very interesting. Seeing a story behind it and reading the symbols to figure out what the artist wants us to tell. Once another artist told me how important it is to create art that tells a story. Not to create only nice looking, smiling, pretty people. Yes, I know it might be beautiful and it's also not wrong to do something pretty without any deep shit. But isn't it more exciting to see feelings and a story in art? Something that lets you think about the picture and not something you look at and that's it. No feelings, nothing but superficial beauty. Sometimes it's just wonderful to dream up while taking a closer look at art. The artist gave me an important lesson just by saying this one sentence. Tell a story with your art. Don't draw only a pretty girl. Tell the story of this pretty girl in this picture. And I really want to continue creating more art like this in the future. Simple pretty drawings are nice, but it's more exciting to tell a story through art, don't you think? Well, I don't know what to tell anymore. Like always, you can find the materials I used in the description box down below and other information too. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and I see you in my next video. Bye bye!